As of now, we have seen how to use mixins, and in the previous one, we have also seen how to pass parameters in the mixin. So means we have seen almost the complete scenario like a function inside the mixins implementation. Now let's cover one more functions concept, that is recursion. That is when a function call itself. Similarly here, when a mixin will call itself will be the recursion in mixins. So let's see the practical implementation of recursion in your mixins.
So in order to implement the recursion here, I have created a function called generateColumns, and here I have given it a call where I passed one parameter. As here you can see in the signature, there are two parameters in generateColumn. One is number, another one is I, means n and I. I is the optional parameter because it is initialized with 1, and here you can see in n I have passed the value 4. So for now, for the first call of this generateColumn, n is 4 and I is 1. Here's the condition. Like here we use the less than equals to operator here in less. So if when I is less than or equal to n, means 1 is less than 4, alright. So what it will do, it will create you one CSS class, that is column at I. The value of I is 1 currently, alright. So the first class is column 1, and the width is going to be 1 into 100, that is 100 only, divide by n, that is 4. So 100 divided by 4 is 25. So for column 1, width will be 25. After that, again I have called this particular column, that is generate columns, in which n will still remain 4. I is now 1, and in another call I am passing value 2. So in another call, n will be 4, I will be 2. 2 is less than 4, so again it will come, it will generate a column 2. 2 into 100 is 200, divided by 4 is 50. So for column 2, it's going to be 50%. The width is going to be 50%. Similarly, it will pass value of n, 4 again. Now the value of I will become 3. N is 4, I is 3. 3 is less than 4, so again it will execute another time. Column 3 will be of 75%, because 3 into 100 is 300, divided by 4 will be 75. And in the last call, n will remain 4, I will be 4. 4 is equal to 4, so column 4 will be 4 into 100 divided by 4, that is 100. So column 4 will be 100, alright. So now if you will call it again, obviously it will be 5, and 5 is not less than 4, so it will be terminated. So this is how it should create me 4 classes. Let's compile and check. And I say yes to all, come to styles.css. And here you can see column 1, column 2, column 3 and column 4. Both are containing different column widths. Alright, so now dependent on your table, you can just apply these classes and can get your desired width.